Hello students, my name is Mangesh and I am faculty at Manoeuvre Education for Maths. So in today's video, we are going to understand how to prepare for Maharashtra MCACET 2020 and how you can specifically prepare for trigonometry. What all topics should you prepare? Okay, from what topic you can expect the major questions for trigonometry, how much questions appear for trigonometry, and what all things you should need to know before attempting the questions for trigonometry for Maharashtra MCACET. Okay, so in this session I will give you a brief introduction about trigonometry, what all topics you should prepare, what is the weightage about the MCACET, and also we are going to solve some questions of trigonometry in the end. So stick till the end to understand what type of questions are expected from you and what type of preparation is expected from you regarding trigonometry to clear MCACET. Okay, so let's get started. Before getting started, I will like to inform you about our classroom sessions. Okay, our new classroom sessions are going to start in Mumbai at BORIVALI, DADAR and VASAI. Okay, batches are both weekdays and weekends. You can join whichever branch and whichever time as per your convenient, or you are living outside Mumbai, you can join our online course. We have awesome videos and awesome mock tests that will help you to clear MCACET. So without any further ado, let's get started. Trigonometry. So in trigonometry for MCACET, you can expect 2 to 3 questions. So 2 to 3 questions, 2 to 3 questions into 4, like, so you can expect around 8 to 12 marks. 8 to 12 marks from trigonometric session. Okay. So which are the major parts? Major parts for trigonometry are trigonometric ratios and identity and trigonometric equations. So around one question you can expect from here, around one question you can expect from here, 1 to 2 questions rather. And sometime a question appears from inverse trigonometry. Okay, so these are the major chunks from where question appears for trigonometry. Okay, so we will understand each topic one by one. First we will go for trigonometric ratios and identity. What is there in trigonometric ratios and identity, you have to study. Okay, so basically these first two parts deal with basics of the trigonometric ratios. These are basics. From here questions will not appear, but this will help to solve you various questions or trigonometric formulas. Okay, so major questions arrive from trigonometric formulas. You might have, so if you have started preparation, you might have been gone through like sum and difference formulas, product formulas, various sine and cos and tan formulas, very tricky formulas, very messy formulas, very difficult to remember formulas. So there are various methods and tricks from where you can remember the formulas. Like there is a hexagon method. From hexagon method you can derive around 16 trigonometric formulas. You can remember 16 trigonometric formulas from one method. Okay, so there are various tricks to remember trigonometric formulas. Okay, and you can expect around 1 to 2 questions from this topic. Okay, so what are there in trigonometric ratios? In trigonometric ratios there is sine, there is cos, there is tan, there is cosec, there is sec, and there is cot. Okay, so these are the trigonometric identities which you have to study. How these trigonometric identities, what are these values of these trigonometric identities, how you can derive the relation between these trigonometric identities, what are their allied angles. Allied angles like 90 minus theta, 180 minus theta, what is 360 minus theta, in which quadrant sine is positive, which quadrant sine is negative, like all smart trigo classes. Okay, so this is first quadrant, this is second quadrant, this is third quadrant, and this is fourth quadrant. Okay, so in first quadrant all the things are positive, like sine, cos, tan, everything will be positive, all smart. So smart means initial for sine. So in second quadrant, whichever value of sine that is positive, here trigo means tan. So in third quadrant all the values of tan is positive, and in fourth quadrant basically all the values of cos are positive. Okay, so these are the allied angles, how you can find 80 plus theta, 180 minus theta. So these type of questions also appear in your trigonometric section. Okay, so there are some of important ratios like 90, 30, 40, 45, 60, And there are various other important results like sine 7 degree, sine 22 and half degree. So there are some important results that you have to remember. We provide detailed analysis on all the topics, whatever type of questions on this topic, what type of questions are appeared on each section. Okay, so we will also tell you about how to, what are the tricks, what are the shortcuts in our videos, and also what are, what type of questions you can expect. So in this way you have a well directed approach to prepare for your exam. Okay, in next section is trigonometric equations. So in trigonometric equations, as you are aware that there is sine, there is cos, there is tan. Okay, so if I tell you this is sine, this is the graph of sine theta. Okay, this is the graph of sine theta. So from this graph of sine theta, you can derive the equation, general equation for trigonometric sine theta. Okay, on this general equations, you can expect a question. So in exam you cannot derive each and every equation, so you should derive all the equations, or you should know general equations of all the formulas. Like you should know at least general equation of sine, cos, tan, sine, a sine square plus b sine square, various. There are 7 to 8 general equations that you should know minimum to solve, attempt the questions of general equations, general trigonometric equations. Okay, so you cannot derive these equations in exam. Okay, for that you should priorly know the general equations of various trigonometric identities. Okay, and there are solutions for more than one equations. If you have more than one equations, how you can generate a solution for that. Okay, and next is inverse trigonometric function. So inverse trigonometric function is nothing but just an extension of trigonometric identities. Okay, so in trigonometric identities you have trigonometric functions, here you have inverse trigonometric functions. Like there is sine theta, so what is inverse trigonometric function? Sine inverse theta. Okay, so this is trigonometric equation, this is inverse trigonometric function. Okay, so sine has a domain and range. Sine is valid for all real values. Okay, maximum value of sine is minus, minimum value of sine is minus, and maximum value of sine is plus. Okay, similarly you have domain and range of inverse trigonometric functions. Similarly you have sum and difference formulas for the trigonometric, inverse trigonometric functions. So if you are thorough with the trigonometric functions, you can easily sell through inverse trigonometric functions. Okay, there are similarly there are important results which you have to remember. So these important results are very much similar to trigonometric identities and ratios. Okay, so if your basics are strong, if your trigonometric ratios and identities and the basic formulas, you know that basic formulas, you can solve any type of questions on trigonometry. So as I told you, we will solve some of the questions so you have a basic idea what type of questions appear. Okay, so there is a question, it is has been asked that what is the maximum value of 3 sine A plus 4 cos A. Okay, so for this we already know the shortcut. For this type of equation, the minimum value is minus under root of A square plus B square. Okay, and maximum value is under root of A square plus B square. Okay, so we will substitute the value of A and B, wherein I will also give you the equation. So A sine x plus B cos x. Okay, for this the minimum value is this, maximum value is this. We will substitute the value in this. So what is A? A is 3, so 3 square is 9. B is 4, 4 square is 16, so 9 plus 16 is 25, under root of 25 is 5. Okay, so in 5 to 10 seconds you have solved a question. Okay, so for this you should know this what is the minimum and maximum value. Okay, so minimum and maximum value are most frequently appearing questions. Okay, rather than one of the most frequently appearing questions are formula based questions, which we'll also do, and minimum maximum values. So minimum maximum values of some of the trigonometric identities and trigonometric relations you have to know by heart before going to your paper. Okay, only then you can solve this type of questions. Okay, now so in this question you can see the identity of sine, the value of 10, 20, 30 is progressively increasing up to 360 degrees. Okay, so if you have attended my session, you can directly mark this as zero. I will tell you how. Okay, for we have just discussed one of the trick, all smart trigo classes. Okay, so this is 0 degree, this is 90 degree, this is 180 degree, and this is 270 degree. Okay, and this is again 360 degree. Okay, so one thing we know, sine 180 plus theta will be minus sine theta, because any value greater than 180 degree will be negative, because sine is positive basically in first and second quadrant only, and it is negative in both the third and fourth quadrant. So I can write sine 190 degree as sine 180 degree plus 10 degrees, which is nothing but minus sine 10 degrees. Similarly, for sine 200, it will be minus 20 degrees, and so on and so forth. So value from sine 10 will get nullified by sine 90, 20 will get nullified by 200, sine 30 will be nullified by sine 210 degrees. Okay, what we will be left is with sine 180 degree and sine 360 degree. But we also know that their value is zero. This is the graph of sine. Okay, and sine is maximum at pi by 2 and minimum at pi, 2 pi, 3 pi, and so on and so forth. Okay, so these both these values are zero, other values get nullified. We can directly say this is that this is the answer. Okay, so if you found this video useful, please like this video, share among your friends, and subscribe our channel to stay connected to further updates. Thank you.